Hi everyone, once again welcome to my channel Unknown Warrior. Before moving towards the today's topic, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon. So today we are going to see object-oriented programming in Python, in which we are going to study method overriding, use of super keyword and customization via inheritance. So first of all, we are going to see method overriding. So what is method overriding? So it is just simply redefining method of base class into derived class. So as shown in the example, first of all, class A is defined, in that we had defined two methods, that is define say and define say hi, and we have printed some message in both the methods. We have taken here class B, which is derived class, and access to the parent class A, in which we have also defined the method C and printed some message say here class B, and we have declared here object B1 that is equals to, which has access to which class? B class. Okay, so basically B1 is the object of class B, and we are accessing two methods using that B1 object, which are say hi and say. So we will get the output as hi and class B. As you can see, class B is derived class of class A. That means that class B can access the member functions or data members of class A. So if we write b1.say hi, where say hi is the method of class A. Okay, that's why here we have got the message as hi. Whereas when we write b1.say, it will access the method of class B instead of class A, because the method say is overridden or redefined in class B. This is nothing but what? Method overriding, that is redefining the method of base class into the derived class. Next is use of super keyword to access members of base class. So here we use the keyword super, which is used to point towards the members of base class. So we have taken same example which we have seen in previous one, that is class A define method say, class B, which is derived class and access to the parent class A, and we have defined two methods in it, define that is say and greet. So let's observe the greet function of class B, in which we have used the keyword super. So how the super, using the super keyword, we access the method of the parent class. So this is the syntax. We write as super in bracket B, which is the current working class, comma self dot C. So this syntax means that we want to access the function say. We have called the function say, which is the method in class A. Okay, so by using super keyword, this is the syntax. Or if I want to access the method of parent class, then I can also write as a dot say in bracket self. So if I want to access the member function of the parent class, I can write it by using super keyword or by using the class name and dot the method name. Okay, and next is self dot say. So here self dot say, I am calling here the function of which class? The derived class. Okay, so when I print b1.greet over here, so it will first give me the output of the called save function, that is class A. So here I have got the output class A, and self.say, where it is the calling function of the class B, so it has printed the message as class B. So this is how we can use super keyword to access members of the base class. Next is customization via inheritance, that is specialization inherited methods. So for customization of an object's response, we use two special functions, that is str and repr. So how we write those functions are underscore underscore str underscore underscore opening and closing round bracket. Similarly, repr underscore underscore repr underscore underscore to round brackets. So let's see them in depth. So basically the special function str is returns only the string representation. So let's observe the example. Again class A, and I have simply written here pass. I don't want to print any statement in the class or any method or any data members in the class. So that's why I have just written the pass statement. In class B, I have defined the special function str. In that, I have written what? The string or a message, that is hello from object of the class B. Here I have taken two objects, A1 which is object of class A and B1 which is object of class B. And I have printed the, when object A1 gets printed, so I have called here object A1. And when object B1 gets printed, I have called object B1. So what will be the output when object A1 gets called? So it will just print, as we have written only pass statement, so it will just give me the address of that object. And when P1 object is called, so it will, or it will show on the screen hello from object of class B. Okay, so that is, it will call the str function over here. Okay, so basically str is a special function which is used to return only the string value. Okay, next is REPR. So this method returns any informatic of object such as tuple, dictionary or list or anything. Same example we have taken, we have just used here what? Define REPR. Okay, that is special method REPR, and we have written here dictionary which has two elements. Then again similar way, we have declared object A1 for, which is the object of class A, B1 which is the object of class B, and we have printed the object A1 and B1. Similarly, as we have nothing written in the class A, so it will just return the object address, whereas when we call the object P1, it will access the REPR function and it will return the dictionary of that particular class. So this was the video in which we have covered object overriding, second was use of super keyword, and the customization of the object. Okay, so this was all for today. Keep watching the video, keep liking, keep subscribing. Thank you.